Frost can affect your crop at all stages of development, reducing yield and quality. Here, Dr. Ben Biddulph, Research Officer with DAFWA, explains how a frost occurs and the contributing environmental factors that will determine severity.
When we have a wet canopy, we get a lot more frost damage than if the canopy was dry, and there's two main reasons because of this. One is because of the wetness, the actual water, the other is because of the ice nucleators which happen in that. So frost is not just freezing damage. There's three main processes which happen with frost. The first two are cold and desiccation. In most of our frost events, that's what we get. So the cold is basically that temperature response, so the diurnal stress of actually going from quite a warm daytime temperature to a low overnight minimum, and then back up to a warm temperature following a frost event. So that cold effect, essentially the plants have to change their membrane fluidity and their energy balance and the processes around that just to cope with that cold stress. So frost initially has that effect of cold. The next effect is desiccation. So when we get a frost event, we get ice. The dew forms on the canopy, and then that dew freezes. After that, it then starts to suck water out of the air. And so it will freeze water from out of the air, but then it will also start to freeze water out of the plant mesophyll cells and out through the stomata itself. So it'll actually start to desiccate the plant tissue and the flag leaf tissue. And quite often after a frost event, you can go out in the morning, and as you see the flag leaves defrost, you'll see them wilt as well. That's because they've lost all of that water from out inside the tissue to the outside. So there's a desiccation effect. So there's these first two processes, and we get that for most frost events. The other effect we get is ice formation and freezing damage. Now, plants of wheat will normally supercool to about minus 10 degrees out in the paddock, but when we add ice nucleators, they'll start to freeze at warmer temperatures. Now, ice nucleators are just like, you know, when you leave your beer in the freezer and you forget to take it out. You know, when you first take it out, if you don't bang it hard or you don't open it, the beer won't freeze. But as soon as you open, they'll break that seal. It'll freeze straight away. And that's because you basically had an ice nucleator come in there. Same thing happens with your wheat out in the paddock. Essentially, when it's at minus 10 degrees or minus 4 or 5 degrees, it'll super cool down to those temperatures and the plant tissue won't freeze. So you only get the cold and desiccation effects. What happens with ice nucleators is they'll actually make your canopy freeze at warmer temperatures. So normally in the paddock, we do have ice nucleators in the form of dust and different bacterial spores on the canopy. And these normally raise the freezing point of those canopies to around minus 5 degrees. But when we have a rainfall event which goes through and actually wets the canopy, those rain droplets bring in with them ice nucleators. And so a lot of those ice nucleators which come with that rainfall event raise the freezing point to around minus 2. So when we have a wet canopy with a lot of these ice nucleators which have been introduced by the rainfall and the rain itself, we end up with a lot more freezing damage because the plant tissue will freeze at minus 2 and won't supercool anywhere near as much. So compared to a dry frost, a frost when you've got a wet canopy always does a lot more damage.